Good evening, and welcome to the Dance of Death. I'm Darby Williams, the director. Before we begin, I'd like to provide a brief content warning. This production contains mentions of emotional and physical abuse, as well as strong language. First and foremost, I'd like to thank my actors and my production team, who have been invaluable throughout this process. This is my first time ever directing a full-length show, so I'm infinitely grateful for the support and the guidance that they've provided me. Now, in the words of Michael Meyer, the translator of this particular edition, the Dance of Death is in the spirit of blackest pessimism. So what that means is that in Strindberg's darkly humorous play, he somehow manages to encapsulate the tragedies and absurdities of life within this deeply tempestuous relationship between these two people. We get to see these characters attempt to cast off the boredom and the inanity of their existence through mutual torment, and ultimately fail to do so. In experiencing the Dance of Death, we're forced to sift through the wreckage not only of the human soul, but of the human mind as well. And once the wreckage is cleared away, we're forced to reckon with what remains. In a time that in particular is characterized by sorrow and absurdity that seem so inextricably intertwined, I hope to tell a story that dissects life and love in all of their contradictions. So I thank you all, and I hope that you enjoy the show.
The RC Players present The Dance of Death, Part 1, by August Strindberg, translated by Michael Meyer. Director Darby Williams, Assistant Director Abby Christian, Producer and Sound Editor Chris Wong, Board Liaison Alexa Moore. Characters: EDGAR, Captain at the Artillery Fortress, played by Alec Korotney. Alice, his wife and ex-actress, played by Quinn Newman. Kurt, Quarantine Master, played by McKenna Forster. Jenny, played by Shayna Lopatin. The Old Woman, played by Stefania Gonzalez, narrated by Stefania Gonzalez. Act 1. The interior of a circular fortress tower. Two large doors with glass panes through which can be seen the seashore. It is a mild autumn evening. The sea is still. The captain is seated in an armchair to the left, fingering a spent cigar. Alice is seated to the right and is doing nothing.
Won't you play something for me?
What shall I play?
What you wish.
You don't like my repertoire.
Nor you mine.
Do you want those doors open?
If you do.
Let them be, then. Why aren't you smoking?
I can't stand strong tobacco nowadays.
Smoke something milder, then. It's your only pleasure, you say.
Pleasure? What's that?
Don't ask me. I'm as ignorant on the subject as you. Don't you want your whiskey yet?
Oh, wait a little. What have you got for dinner?
How should I know? Ask Christine.
Shouldn't we be getting some mackerel soon? It's autumn.
Yes, it's autumn.
Outside and in. But, notwithstanding the chill that comes with autumn, outside and in. A grilled mackerel with a slice of lemon and a glass of white macone is a thought not wholly to be despised.
Quite the orator, aren't you?
Have we any macone left in the cellar?
I wasn't aware we'd had any cellar for the past 5 years.
You are always ill-informed. Well, we'll have to lay some in for our silver wedding.
You really intend to celebrate that?
Naturally.
It would be more natural if we kept our misery private. Our 25 years of misery.
My dear Alice, miserable it has been, but we've had our fun now and then. And one must enjoy the brief time one has, for after that, there is nothing.
Is there nothing? If only we could be sure.
Nothing at all. Just a bare load of muck to fertilize the garden.
All this for a garden.
That's what life is. Don't blame me.
All this. Has the post come?
Yes.
Is the butcher's bill there?
Yes.
How much?
You read it. I can't see anymore.
What's wrong with your eyes?
Don't know.
Age.
Oh, rubbish. Me.
Well, not me. Can you pay this?
Yes, but not now.
Later. In a year, when you're retired on a small pension. That'll be too late, and you'll be ill again.
Ill? I've never been ill, just out of sorts once. I'll live for 20 years.
The doctor thought otherwise.
Ugh, the doctor.
Well, who else should know?
There's nothing wrong with me, and there never has been, and never will be. I'll die with my boots on, as an old soldier should.
Talking of the doctor, you know he's giving a party this evening.
Well, so what? We aren't invited because we don't mix with them, and we don't mix with them because I despise them both. They're trash.
You say that of everyone.
Because everyone is trash.
Except you.
Yes, because I have behaved like a gentleman whatever life has thrown at me. That is why I am not trash.
Do you want to play cards?
Why not?
You know, he's got the regimental band for a private party.
That's because he sneaks off to town with the colonel. Dirty little creeper, if I'd chosen to do that—
I used to be friends with Gerda, but she cheated me.
They're all cheats. What are trumps?
Put your glasses on.
They won't help, come on.
Spades are trumps.
Spades?
Anyway, it's not just them. The new officers' wives don't want anything to do with us either.
What does that matter? We never give parties, so we won't notice. I can manage alone, I always have.
So have I. But the children. The children grow up without knowing anyone.
They'll have to find their own friends in town. My trick. Have you any trumps left?
I've got one. That's mine.
6 and 8 make 15 points.
14.
To... 14. 6 and 8 make 14 points to me. I think I've forgotten how to count. And 2 makes 16.
Oh, your deal.
You're tired.
Not at all.
You can hear the music from here. Do you think Kurt's been invited?
He came this morning, so he's had time to get his tails out, though not to visit us.
Quarantine master. Is there to be a quarantine here?
Yes.
I mean, he is my cousin, and we once shared the same name.
That was no honor.
Look, you forget about my family, and I'll forget about yours.
Now, are we going to start again?
Does the quarantine master have to be a doctor?
No, he's just a kind of administrator and bookkeeper. And Kurt's never been either.
Well, he's had a hard life.
He cost me money. And when he left his wife and children, he lost what honor he had.
There's no need to be so harsh, Edgar.
Well, it's true. Remember what happened later in America? Well, I can't say I miss him, but he was a nice lad and I liked arguing with him.
Because he always gave in.
gave in. At least he was a man one could talk to. On this island, there isn't anyone who understands what I say. It's a community of imbeciles.
It's strange that Kurt should come just at the time of our silver wedding, whether we celebrate it or not.
Why is that strange? Oh, I see. Yes, it was he who brought us together. Married you off was the phrase they used.
Well, he did, didn't he?
Oh, yes. He got some idea into his head, and, well, you should know best.
It was just a whim.
Which we have had to suffer for, not he.
Yes, think if I'd stayed in the theater. All my friends are stars now.
Oh-ho, we're back there, are we? Oh, have a whiskey. We ought to have a rail to rest our feet on. Then we could dream we were in Copenhagen at the old American bar.
We must have one made if it'll remind us of Copenhagen. Those were our happiest days, in spite of everything.
Yes. Do you remember Nim's Charlotte Russe?
No, but I remember the concerts at Tivoli.
You have such refined taste, my dear.
You should be proud at having a wife with taste.
I am.
When you need to boast about her.
They must be dancing at the doctor's now. I can hear the trombones. Oom-pa-pa, oom-pa-pa.
I can hear the Alcazar waltz. Yes. It's a long time since I danced a waltz.
Could you still manage it?
Oh, still?
Well, you're done with dancing, aren't you? Like me?
I'm 10 years younger than you.
Then we are the same age, since the lady is always 10 years younger.
Oh, stuff. You're an old man. I'm in my prime.
But of course, you can be delightful to other men when you try.
Can we light the lamp now?
Why not?
Ring, then.
Jenny, would you mind lighting the lamp,
please? Light the lamp!
Very good, madame.
Have you dried the glass properly?
Yes. All it needs.
How dare you answer like that?
Alice, please.
Get out! I'd better light the lamp myself.
Yes, I think you had.
Go!
I wonder what you'd say if I did.
Do you think she will go?
Wouldn't surprise me. We'll be in a hole if she does.
It's your fault. You spoil them.
Nonsense. They're always polite to me.
Because you cringe to them. You cringe to all subordinates because you're a bully with a slave's mentality.
Ooh, very clever.
Yes, you cringe to your men and your junior officers, but you can't come to terms with your equals and your superiors.
Pah!
You're like all bullies. Do you think she'll leave?
Yes, if you don't go and talk nicely to her.
I?
If I did, you'd say I was flirting with the servants.
Oh, think if she does go. Then I'll have to do all the work again and ruin my hands.
I can imagine worse things, but if Jenny goes, Christine will go. And then we shan't get another servant to come to this island. The ferry pilot frightens off every girl who comes to apply. And if he forgets to, my sentries will.
Oh yes, your sentries, whom I have to feed in my kitchen, and whom you haven't the courage to order out.
If I did, they'd go too, and we'd be left without a garrison.
But it's ruining us.
Which is why the mess committee intend to apply to His Majesty for a subsistence allowance.
For us?
No, for the sentries.
You're crazy.
Yes, laugh a little for me. We need some mirth.
I'll soon have forgotten how to laugh.
One must never forget that. It's a bit of a bore, though.
It certainly isn't funny. Do you want to go on playing?
No, it tires me.
You know, it does annoy me that my cousin, our new quarantine master, should pay his respects to our enemies before he comes and sees us.
Oh? Why bother about that?
Well, did you see in the paper that the list of arrivals described him as of independent means? That means he must have come into money.
Independent means? Indeed. A rich relation, first we've ever had in this family.
In your family? We've had plenty of rich ones in mine.
He's got a hold of some money, so he's giving himself airs. But I know how to play him. He won't get a look at my cards.
Who's that?
Quiet, a moment, please.
Well, go and see what it says.
I can hear. I hear what they're saying. It's the children.
Well?
Wait a moment. It's the children. Judith is ill again. She's staying away from school.
Again? What else did they say?
Money, of course.
Why does Judith have to be in such a hurry? If she took her exams next year, it'd be soon enough.
You tell her that and see what good it does.
You should tell her.
How many times haven't I? You should know that children do as they please.
In this house, anyway.
Ooh.
Must you yawn in your wife's presence?
What else is there to do? Haven't you noticed that every day we say the same things? When just now you said you're inevitable, in this house anyway, I should have replied as usual, it's not just my house. But since I've given that answer 500 times already, I merely yawned. My yawn could mean I can't be bothered to reply, or you are right, my angel, or for God's sake, let's stop.
You're being really charming tonight.
Won't it be time for dinner soon?
Do you know the doctor has ordered supper from the Grand Hotel, on the mainland?
No? Then they'll be having grouse. There's no finer bird than grouse, but one mustn't roast it in lard.
Ugh, must you talk about food?
You prefer wine? I wonder what those Philistines will drink with grouse.
Shall I play for you?
The last resort. Yes, as long as we don't have any of your funeral marches and Jeremiah ads. There's no need to underline the obvious. I can always fill in the words. Hear how miserable I am. Meow, meow. Hear what a frightful husband I have. Brum, brum, brum. If only he would die. Kettle drums, fanfares. And we end with the Alcazar waltz and a champagne gallop. Talking of champagne, we have 2 bottles left. Shall we open them and pretend we've guests?
No, we won't. They're mine. I bought them myself.
Always careful with the purse strings, aren't you?
And you're always mean. To your wife, at any rate.
Then I've no further ideas. Shall I dance for you?
No, thank you. You're too old to dance.
You should have a female companion to live with you.
Thank you. You should have a male.
Thank you. That was tried, and the result was mutual dissatisfaction. But interesting as an experiment. I mean that as soon as a stranger entered the house, you and I became so happy, to begin with.
But afterwards...
Yes, let's not talk of that.
Who can that be at this hour?
Jenny doesn't usually knock.
Go and open it, and don't shout, come in, as though you were in an office.
You don't like anything associated with work, do you?
Well, open it.
It's Christine. Has Jenny left? Jenny's left.
I'll have to be a housemaid again, then.
And I a valet.
Can't we use one of the men from the kitchen?
One can't do that nowadays.
That card can't have been Jenny's, surely.
You read it. I can't.
Kurt. It's Kurt. Go out and greet him.
Kurt? Well, how nice. Well, here he is, the renegade. Welcome, my dear chap. Good to see you.
Welcome to my house, Kurt.
Thank you. It's been a long time.
What is it, 15 years? And we've grown old.
Oh, Kurt hasn't changed, I don't think.
Sit down, sit down. Now, first of all, what's your program? Are you booked for dinner tonight?
I've been invited to the doctor's, but I haven't promised to come.
Then you'll stay with us.
That would seem the most natural thing, since you are my relatives. But the doctor is my boss, and it might be awkward later.
What nonsense! I've never been scared of my bosses.
I didn't say I was scared. Just might be awkward.
On this island, I am the master. You get behind me, and no one will dare to harm
me. Be quiet now, Edgar. Never mind about bosses and masters. You stay here with us. People will think that natural and correct.
Very well, then. You certainly make me feel welcome here.
Why shouldn't you be welcome? We've no quarrel, have we? Well, what could there be? You were a bit thoughtless once, but you were young and I've forgotten it. I don't bear grudges.
Well, you've been out in the wide world?
Yes, and now I'm back here with both of you.
Whom you married off 25 years ago.
I didn't quite do that, but never mind. It's good to see you're still together after...
Yes, we've managed. We've had our ups and downs, but, as you say, we're still together. And Alice has no cause to complain. Everything's gone fine. Money has been pouring in. Perhaps you don't know that I'm a famous author in the educational field?
Oh, yes. I remember when we last saw each other, you'd published a rifle instruction handbook that had gone well. Do they still use it in the army schools?
Or? It's still in print, and it's still the best, though they've tried to replace it with an inferior one, which gets read but is quite worthless.
You've been abroad, I hear.
Yes, we've been to Copenhagen. 5 times, imagine.
Yes! You see, when I took Alice out of the theater...
Took? You?
Well, yes. I took you as a wife should be taken.
How dashing of you.
But since it was subsequently shoved down my throat that I had cut short her brilliant career, I had to make up for this by promising to take my wife to Copenhagen. And that promise I have kept, like a gentleman. 5 times we have been there? 5. Have you been in Copenhagen?
No, I've mostly been in America.
America?
That must be a frightful country, nothing but gangsters.
Well, it isn't Copenhagen.
Have you heard anything from your children?
No.
Forgive me, Kurt, dear, but it was rather thoughtless of you to leave them like you did.
I didn't leave them. The court awarded custody to their mother.
Let's not discuss that now. I think you were well out of that mess.
How are your children?
Oh, fine, thank you. They're at school in town. They're almost grown up.
Yes, they're clever kids. The boy's got a brilliant brain. Brilliant. He's going on to the general staff soon.
If they take him.
If? He'll be the Minister of Defense.
Changing the subject. There's going to be a quarantine here. Bubonic plague, cholera, and all of that. As you know, I'll be working under the doctor. What kind of chap is he?
Chap? He isn't a chap. He's an ignorant rogue.
Oh, how very unpleasant for me.
Well, he's not as bad as Edgar makes out, but I can't say I like him.
He's a rogue, and so are all the others. The excise officer, the postmaster, the telephone woman, the chemist, the pilot, the... What does he call himself? The alderman. They're all a pack of rogues, which is why I have nothing to do with them.
Are you at loggerheads with all of them?
All?
Yes, it's true. One really can't associate with such people.
Every bullying little bureaucrat in the country seems to have been sent here.
Everyone.
Is that a reference to me? I'm no bully, at any rate, not in my own house.
I'd like to see you try.
You mustn't listen to what she says. I am a very good husband, and my old lady's the best wife in the world.
Kurt, would you like a drink?
Thank you. Not now.
Have you become a...
I just don't drink much.
America?
Yes.
I don't go with moderation. A man ought to be able to hold his drink.
These neighbors of yours. My job, I shall have to meet them all. And it'll be tricky because even if one doesn't want to get involved, one gets involved in other people's intrigues.
You go and meet them. You'll always come back to us. We're your true friends.
Isn't it horrible to sit alone surrounded by enemies like you do?
It isn't fun.
It isn't at all horrible. I've had nothing but enemies all my life, and they've helped me on my way, not harmed me. And when I have to die, I shall be able to say that I have never received anything gratis. Every stick I own, I've had to fight for.
Yes, Edgar's path has not been paved with roses.
With thorns, stones, flints, I've had to trust in my own strength. Same with you?
I learned the inadequacy of that 10 years ago.
Then you're pathetic.
Edgar!
Well, yes, he's pathetic if he doesn't trust in his own strength. It's true that when the mechanism runs down, you're a barrelload of shit to scatter over the garden. But as long as the cogs go round, you must kick and fight with your fists and your feet. As long as the threads hold together, that is my philosophy.
You're fun to listen to.
But don't you think I'm right?
No, I don't.
Well, it's the truth anyways.
You'll stay with us for supper.
Thank you. If I may.
But it'll be very simple. Our maid has left.
That'll suit me.
Dear Kurt, you're so unpretentious.
Extraordinary how the barometer's fallen. I felt it.
He's so nervous.
Well, we ought to eat soon.
I'll go and see to it. You two sit down and philosophize. Don't contradict him or he'll lose his temper. And don't ask why he never became a major.
Cook us something worth eating now, old lady!
Give me some money, and I will.
Always money. Money, money, money. I spend the whole day opening my purse so that I finally come to believe I am a purse. Do you know that feeling?
Oh, yes. The only difference was I used to think I was a wallet.
You've sucked that lemon too, huh? These women. And you've caught a real tartar.
Oh. Let's forget that now.
She was a proper pearl, whereas mine's a good woman, for all her faults. She's all right for all her faults.
For all her faults.
Don't laugh, damn you.
For all her faults.
Yes, she's been a faithful wife and an excellent mother, first rate. It's just that... she's got a devilish temper. Do you know there have been moments when I've cursed you for saddling me with her?
But I didn't. Look here, old chap.
Oh, come on. You're talking rubbish. You forget things you don't want to remember. Oh, don't take it amiss. I'm used to ordering people around and swearing at them. You know me. I know you won't take offense.
Of course not. But I didn't get you your wife. Quite the opposite.
Life's odd, though, don't you think?
I suppose it is.
And getting old. It isn't nice, but it's interesting. Oh, I'm no age, but I'm beginning to feel it. All one's acquaintances die off, and one feels so alone.
Lucky the man who has a wife to grow old with.
Lucky? Yes, I suppose you're right. One's children leave one, too. You shouldn't have left yours.
But I didn't. They were taken from me.
Now you mustn't get angry when I mention it.
But it didn't happen like—
Well, whether it did or not, it's forgotten now, but you're on your own.
One can get used to anything, my dear fellow.
Can one? Can one get used to being quite alone?
Well, look at me.
What have you been doing these 15 years?
What a question. I mean, 15 years.
They say you've come into money and are rich.
I wouldn't say rich.
I'm not trying to touch you.
If you were, I'd gladly—
Thank you very much, but I have money. You see, there must be no want in this house. The day I had no money, she would leave me.
Oh, no, it's—
No? I know it. Would you believe it? She always remarks on it when I'm out of money, just for the pleasure of impressing it on me that I don't look after my family.
But you have a big income, I remember you saying.
Well, certainly I have a big income, but it isn't big enough.
Then it can't be big in the usual sense.
Life is strange, and so are we.
What is that?
Only a time signal.
Haven't you a telephone?
Yes, in the kitchen, but we use the telegraph because the telephone operators repeat everything we say.
It must be dreadful for you all living out here.
It's perfectly gruesome. All life is gruesome. Kurt, you believe in an afterlife. Do you suppose we shall find peace afterwards?
I suppose there'll be storms and strife there, too.
There, too. If there's any there, better if there is nothing.
Can you be sure that annihilation would happen without pain?
I shall die snap without pain.
You're sure of that?
Yes, I know it.
You don't seem content with your existence.
Content? The day I'm allowed to die, I shall be content.
You can't be sure of that. But tell me, what do you do in this house? What happens here? The walls, they smell of poison. One feels ill the moment one enters. I'd like to leave if I hadn't promised Alice to stay. There are corpses under the floorboards. There's such hatred here. It's difficult to breathe. What's the matter? Edgar! Edgar!
Did you say something? Oh, I thought it was Alice. Oh, it's you? Look,
This is horrible! Alice!
What is it?
I don't know! Look at him!
He goes off like that sometimes. I'll play some music, then he'll wake up.
No, don't do that! Let me look at him. Can he hear? Can he see?
Now he can neither hear nor see.
You can say that so calmly. Alice, what is going on in this house?
Ask that thing.
That thing? He's your husband.
To me, he's a stranger. As much a stranger as he was 25 years ago. I know nothing about that man, except that—
Hush! He can hear you.
He can hear nothing.
Excuse me! I must just inspect the sentries.
Is he ill?
I don't know.
Is he out of his mind?
I don't know!
Does he drink?
Not as much as he boasts he does.
Sit down and tell me, but calmly, and the truth.
What shall I say? That I've sat in this tower for a lifetime, a prisoner, kept from life by a man I have always hated, and whom I now hate so boundlessly that the day he died I would laugh for joy.
Why haven't you parted?
You may well ask. We parted twice when we were engaged. We've tried to part ever since, every day, but we're welded together and can't prise ourselves loose. Once we did part, in here without leaving the house. Once in 5 years. Now only death can part us. We know that, and so we await him as a liberator.
Why are you so alone, the two of you?
Because he isolates me. First, he rooted out all my brothers and sisters from the house. That's the phrase he used, rooted out. Then my woman friends and others.
But his relatives, did you root them out?
Yes, they would have robbed me of my life once they'd robbed me of my honor. In the end, I had to maintain contact with the outside world through that telegraph, because the telephone operators eavesdropped on our conversations. I taught myself to use the telegraph, though he doesn't know that. You mustn't tell him or he'll kill me.
Oh, horrible. Horrible. Why does he blame me for your marriage? You remember how it was. Edgar and I were friends. He fell in love with you as soon as he saw you, came to me and begged me to act as intermediary. I refused, and my dear Alice, I knew how cruel and tyrannical you could be, so I warned him. When he persisted, I told him to get your brother to plead his cause to you.
I believe you. But he's been lying to himself about it all these years, and you'll never be able to persuade him otherwise.
Well, let him blame me if it'll make him feel easier.
That's too much to ask.
Oh, I'm used to it. But what does hurt me is his saying that I abandoned my children. It's quite untrue.
Oh, that's his way. He says what he thinks and then believes it. But he seems fond of you, mostly because you don't contradict him. Do try to go along with us. I think you came here at a lucky moment for us, really. It's an act of providence. Kurt, you must help us. We're the most miserable couple on earth.
I've seen one marriage at close quarters. That was frightening. But this is almost worse.
You think so?
Yes.
Whose fault is it?
Alice, the moment you stop asking whose fault it is, things will be easier. Try to accept it as a fact, as a trial which must be endured.
I can't. It's too much. Ugh, it's so hopeless.
Unhappy people. Do you know why you hate each other?
No. It's got no logic, no grounds, no purpose, but no end. Can you imagine what he fears most from death? He fears that I shall remarry.
Then he does love you.
So it seems, but that doesn't prevent him hating me.
Is what men call the hatred of love and is born in hell. Does he like you to play for him?
Yes, but only ugly tunes. This frightful march of the boyars. When he hears that, he becomes possessed and wants to dance.
Does he dance?
Yes, he has these whims.
One thing, forgive my asking, where are the children?
Two of them died, did you know?
You've been through that too.
What haven't I been through?
But the other two?
They're in town. They couldn't live at home. He turned them against me.
And you turned them against him?
Of course. And then we had political intrigues, canvassing, bribes. In the end, we sent the children away so as not to destroy them. What should have been our bond divided us. What should have been a blessing became a curse. Sometimes I think we belong to a race that is cursed.
Well, yes. We are. Since we first sinned.
What do you mean?
Adam and Eve.
Oh. I thought you meant something else. Kurt, we're cousins. You've been my friend since childhood. I haven't always treated you as I should. But now, I'm punished, and you have your revenge on me.
Revenge? I have taken no revenge, Alice.
Do you remember one Sunday when you were engaged? I'd invited you to dinner.
Alice!
I must talk, please. When you arrived, we were out and you had to go away.
You'd been invited out yourself. What does that matter now?
Kurt, when just now I invited you to dine with us, I thought there was something in the larder. And there's nothing. Not even a piece of bread.
Poor, poor Alice.
But when he comes back and wants something to eat and there isn't anything, he'll get angry. You've never seen him angry. Oh, God, this humiliation.
Why not let me go out and get something?
There is nothing to get on this island.
Look, I couldn't care less, but for his sake and yours, let me think up something. Something we must laugh it off as a joke. When he comes back, I'll suggest we have a drink, then I'll think up something. Get him in a good humor. Play some game with him, it doesn't matter what. You sit down at the piano and be ready.
Look at my hands. What are they to play with? I have to scour the pots and dry the glasses, lay the fires, clean the house.
But you have two servants.
We have to say we have, because he's an officer. But they're always leaving, so that sometimes we have none at all. Most of the time. How shall I get out of this business about supper? If only the house would burn down!
Alice! Oh. Don't say such things!
Or the sea would rise and swallow us up!
No, no, no! I can't listen to you.
What will he say? What will he say? Don't go, Kurt. Don't leave me.
No, Alice. I won't go.
Oh, yes, but when you have gone...
Has he struck you?
Me? Oh, no. Well, then he knows I would go. One must cling to a little pride.
Is that him?
Yes.
What on earth shall we do?
I don't know. I don't know.
Oh, there! Now I'm free. Well, Kurt, now she's had the chance to beat her breast. Makes her heart bleed, doesn't it?
What's the weather like out there?
Oh, there's a storm blowing up. Baron Bluebird with the maiden in his tower, and outside stalks the sentry with drawn saber to guard the fair virgin. Along come her brothers, but there goes the sentry, see? Left! Right! He's a good watchdog, look at him! Tum-tiddy-tum-tum-tum-tiddy-tum. Shall we dance the sword dance? Kurt should see that.
No. Let's have the March of the Boyars instead.
Oh, you know that? Alice, sit down in your apron and play. Play, I say. You've been telling lies about me.
I... give an encore. Blessed Jesus!
What's happened? What is it?
Is he dead?
I don't know. Help me.
I can't touch him. Is he dead?
No. He's alive.
Ugh.
What has happened? What has happened?
You fell.
Did something happen?
You fell on the floor. Is something the matter?
With me? Nothing at all. Not that I'm aware of. What are you staring at?
You're ill.
Oh, rubbish. Go on playing, Alice. Ow! There it is again.
There. You see? You are ill.
Don't shout. I'm just a bit dizzy.
We must get the doctor. I'll go and telephone.
I don't want any doctor.
You must. We must get him for our sake. Otherwise, it'll be our responsibility.
If he comes, I'll kick him out. I'll put a bullet in him. Ow! Again.
I'll go and telephone.
Will you give me a glass of water?
I suppose I must.
Charming.
Are you ill?
Forgive me for not being well.
Do you want to nurse yourself, then?
You don't want to nurse me, do you?
What do you think?
The moment has come for which you have waited so long.
Yes, and which you thought would never come.
Don't be angry with me.
It's monstrous.
What did he say?
He rang off. just like that.
Well, now you see the result of your arrogance.
I think I'm feeling worse. Try to get a doctor from town.
I'll have to telegraph then.
Can you telegraph?
Yes, I can.
I see. Well, do it then. Damned liar she is. Kurt, come and sit beside me. Hold my hand. I'm sitting and falling. Can you imagine that? Down, down. Strange.
Have you had these attacks before?
Never.
While you're waiting for a reply from town, I'll go to the doctor and talk to him. He's attended you before.
He has.
Then he knows your background.
I'll get a reply soon. Thank you, Kurt, but come back quickly.
As quickly as I can.
He's a good fellow, Kurt. How he's changed.
Yes, and for the better. I pity him, though, getting mixed up with us just now.
On our Silver Jubilee. I wonder how things are with him, really. Did you notice he didn't want to talk about that?
Yes, I noticed, though I don't think anyone asked him.
What a life he's had. And us. I wonder if everyone's life is like this.
Perhaps, though they don't talk about it like we do.
Sometimes I've thought that misery attracts misery, and that happy people somehow avoid disaster. Which is why we shall never know anything but misery.
Have you known any happy people?
Let me think. No. Yes, the Eckmarks.
How can you say that? She had that operation last year.
That's true. Well, I don't know. Yes, the Crafts.
Oh, yes, they all lived an idyllic existence. Rich, respected, nice children, good marriages. Till the parents were 50. Then their cousin comes along, turns out to be a criminal, gets sent to prison, and that was the end of their happiness. Their name was plastered across every newspaper, and they didn't dare show their face in the street. The children had to be taken away from school. Dear God.
I wonder what I've got.
What do you think it is?
My heart or my head. It's as though my soul wanted to fly out of my body and disappear in a cloud of smoke.
Do you feel like some food?
Yes. What have we got for supper?
I'll ask Jenny.
She's left.
Oh. Yes, of course.
Ring for Christine to bring me some fresh water.
Imagine. She doesn't hear.
Go outside and see if... Imagine if she's left, too.
What's this? Her trunk standing packed in the corridor.
Then she has left.
Oh, this is hell.
And all at once. And of course, Kurt has to come and see the mess we're in. Just to add an extra humiliation, he has to come just now.
Do you know what I think? I think he's gone, too, and won't come back.
I can believe that of him.
Yes, we are cursed.
What's that?
Well, don't you see how everyone shuns us?
Let them! There's your answer. Quiet. I'm listening. No one has time. They're avoiding us. The scum.
That's the result of abusing your doctors and neglecting to pay them.
That's not true.
Even when you could, you wouldn't pay them because you despise their work, just as you've despised my work and everyone else's. Now they won't come. And the telephone's cut off because you didn't think that worth having either. Nothing's worth anything to you except your rifles and cannons.
Don't stand there talking rubbish.
Everything comes back. Life is a circle.
Superstitious nonsense! An old wives' tale.
You'll see. Do you know we owe Christine 6 months' salary?
Well, she's stolen that much.
But I've had to borrow money from her.
I can believe that of you.
Oh, how ungrateful you are. You know I only did it so that the children could visit us.
You know, Kurt chose a good time. He's a rogue like the rest of them. And a coward. Didn't dare say he'd had enough of us and that it'd be more fun at the doctor's ball. Probably knew we'd give him a rotten supper. That bastard hasn't changed.
My dear Edgar. Look, it's like this. The doctor knows all about your heart.
Heart?
Yes. I've had a bad heart for some time. A hardening.
An ossifying of the heart?
And...
Is it dangerous?
Well...
Is it dangerous?
Yes.
Death?
You must be very careful. First, no more cigars. And no more whiskey. Then you must go to bed.
No, not that. Not bed. Then it's the end. Then one never gets up again. I'll sleep on the sofa tonight. What else did he say?
He was very friendly, and he says he'll come at once if you ask him.
Friendly, was he, the hypocrite? I don't want to see him. Can I eat?
Not tonight. And for the next few days, only milk.
Milk? Oh, I can't stand the stuff.
You'll have to learn.
No, I'm too old to learn. Ow! There it is again.
What did the doctor say?
That he may die.
Oh, thank God.
Oh, take care, Alice. Take care. And now, go and get a pillow and blanket, and I'll lay him on the sofa. Then I'll sit in this chair all night.
And I?
You go to bed. Your presence seems to worsen his condition.
Order and I'll obey. I know you want to help us both.
Both, Alice. I'm taking no sides in this.
So they've left me, the rogues. Who's that? What do you want?
I only wanted to shut the door, kind sir.
Why? Why?
Because it blew open just as I was going past.
You were going to steal, you old devil!
There's not much to take here. Christine told me.
Christine.
Good night, sir. Sleep well.
Who was that at the door? Was there someone?
Yes, old Maya from the workhouse. She was just walking past.
Are you sure?
Are you frightened?
Frightened? Of course not.
If you won't go to bed, you'd better lie here.
I want to lie here. Kurt, don't leave me.
I'll stay with you all night. Alice is going to bed.
Good night then, Alice.
Good night. Kurt.
Good night. Won't you take off your boots?
No. A warrior must always be ready for action.
Are you expecting a battle?
Perhaps. Kurt, you are the only person I have opened my heart to. Listen. If I die tonight... Remember my children.
I will.
Thank you. I trust you.
Can you explain why you trust me?
While we haven't been friends, I don't believe in friendship, and our two families were born enemies and have always fought each other.
And yet you trust me.
Yes. And I don't know why. Do you think I'm going to die?
Like everyone else? There'll be no exception made for you.
Are you bitter?
Yes. Are you afraid of death? The wheelbarrow in the garden?
Suppose it isn't the end.
Many think it's not.
Well, what then?
Just surprises, I suppose.
But one knows nothing for sure.
No, that's just it. So one must be prepared for everything.
You aren't so stupid as to believe in hell.
Don't you, who are in the midst of it?
I was only speaking metaphorically.
The way you described yours wasn't metaphorical. Poetic or otherwise.
If you only knew the agonies I suffer.
Bodily?
No, they aren't bodily.
Then they must be spiritual. There's no third kind.
I don't want to die!
Just now you were longing for annihilation.
Yes, if it's painless!
But it isn't.
Is this annihilation then?
The beginning of it.
Good night.
Good night.
Is he asleep?
Yes, since sunrise.
What sort of a night?
He slept in snatches, but he's been talking so much.
What about?
He's been going on about religion like a schoolboy. Seems to think he's solved the problems of existence. Finally, towards dawn, he discovered the immortality of the soul.
His soul, of course.
Absolutely. He really is the most arrogant creature I've ever met. I am, therefore God exists.
So you've realized that. Look at those boots. With them, he'd have trampled the earth flat if he'd had the chance. With them, he has trampled on other men's fields and flowers, other men's hearts, and my brain. Now the wild boar feels the hunter's knife.
He'd be comic if it weren't tragic. It's strange, but in all his meanness, there's a kind of grandeur. Can't you find one good word to say about him?
I could, but not for him to hear. One word to encourage him, and his arrogance exceeds all limits.
He can't hear anything. I've given him morphine.
Well, he was born in a poor home, one of a large family. From an early age, he had to support them by giving lessons because his father was an idler, or worse. It must be hard for a young man to have to give up his youth to slave for a pack of ungrateful brats who weren't even his own. I remember first seeing him when I was a little girl. It was winter. 25 below zero, and he hadn't even an overcoat, though they all had. I thought it was noble, and I admired him for it. But his ugliness frightened me. He is unusually ugly, isn't he?
Yes, sometimes repulsively so. I noticed it particularly every time I quarreled with him, and then when he wasn't there, his image grew, took on strange forms and monstrous proportions. He literally began to haunt me.
How do you suppose it must be for me, then? Oh, I suppose those first years as an officer must have been a martyrdom for him. He got help now and then, but he'll never admit it. And everything he could get, he took as his due without a word of thanks.
We ought to speak charitably of him.
After he's dead? Yes. Well, then I'll say no more.
Do you think he's evil?
Yes. And yet... he can be kind and sensitive. But if he hates you, he's a monster.
Why didn't he become a major?
Does it surprise you? They didn't want to have a man over them who'd already proved himself a tyrant under them. But you must never mention that. He says he didn't want to become a major. Did he say anything about the children?
Yes. He wanted to see, Judith.
I can imagine. Do you know who Judith is? She's the spit of him, and he's trained her to oppose me. Would you believe it? My own daughter has raised her hand against me.
Surely not.
Hush! He's moving. I wonder if he heard us. He's cunning, too.
Yes. He's waking up.
Doesn't he look like the devil himself? I'm frightened of him.
It's morning. At last.
How are you feeling?
Bad.
Would you like to see a doctor?
No, I want to see Judith, my child.
Don't you think you should make arrangements before... in case anything happens?
What do you mean? What should happen?
What can happen to everyone?
Oh, rubbish. I won't die that easily, believe me. Don't start celebrating in advance, Alice.
Think of your children. Make your will so that at least your wife can be sure of her furniture.
You want her to inherit my possessions while I'm still alive?
No, but if anything should happen, you don't want her to be thrown out on the road. Someone who for 25 years has cleaned, dusted, and polished this furniture should have some right to it. Shall I get a lawyer?
No.
You're a cruel man. Crueler than I thought.
Ow! There it is again.
Go, Alice. There's little we can do here.
Well, Kurt, how are you planning to arrange this quarantine?
Oh, I shall manage.
No, I'm in charge on this island, and you've got to deal with me. Don't forget that.
Have you ever seen a quarantine?
Have I? Yes, before you were born. And I'll give you some advice. Don't put the disinfection ovens too close to the shore.
I thought they ought to be close to the water.
That shows how much you know about your job. Water is the natural element of germs. They thrive in it.
But salt water is necessary to cleanse away the impurities.
Imbecile. Well, as soon as you've found somewhere to live, you must bring your children to join you.
Do you think they'll come?
Of course. If you show yourself a man. It'll make a good impression on people here if you make it clear that you know your duties in that field.
I have always fulfilled my duties in that field.
In that field where your weakness is most painfully evident.
Haven't I told you?
I mean, one doesn't leave one's children like that.
Oh! Carry on.
As your kinsman and as the senior member of the family, I feel a certain duty to tell you the truth, even when it is most painful. And you mustn't take offense.
Are you hungry?
Yes, I am.
Would you like something light?
No, something strong.
That would finish you.
Isn't it enough to be ill one must starve to?
That's the way it is.
And no drinking or smoking. Then life's not worth much.
Death demands sacrifice. Otherwise, he comes at once.
These are for you.
For me? May I see them?
Yes, they're only from the junior officers, the band, and the sentries.
You're jealous.
Oh, no. If they were laurel wreaths, that would be different, but those you'll never get.
Well, here is a telegram from the colonel. Read it, Kurt. At least he's a gentleman, though he is a little fool. This one's from... What's this? It's from Judith. Be so good as to telegraph her to come by the next ship. This one... Well, one isn't without friends after all. It's a comfort that people think without fear or reproach of a sick man who deserves more recognition than he has been granted.
I don't understand. Are they congratulating you on being ill?
Hyena.
Yes, we had a doctor here who was so hated that when he left the island, they gave a banquet after he'd gone.
Put the flowers in vases. I'm not a credulous man, and humanity is scum. But this simple homage, by God, it comes from the heart. It cannot but come from the heart.
Imbecile.
Judith says that she cannot come because the steamer has been delayed by a storm.
Is that all?
No. There is something more.
Out with it!
Well, she asks you not to drink so much.
My God. That's children for you. My only beloved daughter, my Judith, my idol.
And your spit.
This is life. The best life has to offer. Shit.
Well, you sowed this harvest yourself. You taught her to rebel against her mother, now she turns against her father, and you say there is no God.
What does the colonel write?
He grants you leave from all duties forthwith.
Leave? I haven't asked for any leave.
No, but I have.
I won't accept it.
Well, the arrangements have already been made.
I don't care.
You see, Kurt... For this man, no laws exist, no rules apply, no human authority matters. He stands above everything and everyone. The universe has been created for his private benefit. The sun and the moon are merely his messengers to carry his orders to the stars. That's my husband. This insignificant captain who couldn't even become a major, whose puffed-up pride is a laughingstock to those who he supposes fear him. This coward, who's afraid of the dark and believes that all the discoveries of science are merely the build-up to his grand finale. A barrel-load of manure, and that not of the top quality.
Have you invited Kurt to lunch?
No.
Then go at once to the kitchen and grill the two best steaks you can find.
Two?
Well, I propose to have one too.
But we are three.
You want one too? Very well then. Three.
Where do you expect me to find them? Last night you invited Kurt to supper and there wasn't a crust of bread in the house. Kurt has had to sit up all night with you on an empty stomach and hasn't even had a cup of coffee because we haven't got any and our credit is finished.
She's angry with me because I didn't die yesterday.
No, because you didn't die 25 years ago. Because you didn't die before I was born.
Listen to her. That's what happens when you matchmake, my dear Kurt. Our marriage certainly wasn't arranged in heaven. However, say what you may, I am going about my duty. Get away from me!
Yes, go. That's what you always do. Turn your back when things become too much for you and make your wife cover your retreat. Drunkard, braggart, liar!
Is there no limit to this?
You haven't seen the worst.
Worse than this?
Don't ask me.
Where is he going now? And where does he find the strength?
You may well ask. Oh, now he'll go down to his lieutenants and thank them for the flowers. And then he'll eat and drink with them. And he calls them scum. If you knew how many times he's been threatened with dismissal. But it's only out of pity for his family that they've spared him. And he thinks it's because they're scared of him. And these wretched officers' wives who've tried to help us, he hates them and calls trash.
I must confess, I applied for this job in the hope of finding some peace down here by the sea. I had no idea how things were with you two.
Poor Kurt. What will you do for food?
Oh, I'll get something at the doctor's. But what about you? Can't I arrange something for you?
You mustn't know or he'll kill me.
Look, he's standing out on the rampart. In this wind.
One can't but pity him, that he is the way he is.
I pity both of you. But what is to be done?
I don't know. And a heap of bills has come, too, which, of course, he didn't notice.
It can be a blessing not to be able to see sometimes.
Now he's opened his coat and is letting the wind blow against his chest. He wants to die.
I don't think he does. Just now, when he felt his life was slipping away, he clutched onto mine. He began to smuggle his way into my private affairs as though he wanted to worm into me and live my life.
That's his way. He's a vampire. He likes to sink his claws into other people's destinies, suck excitement out of other lives, batten on others because his own life is so totally boring to him. Remember this, Kurt. Never let him into your life. Never let him know your friends, or he'll take them from you and make them his. He's a real demon at that. If he ever meets your children, you'll soon find them regarding him as their father. They'll follow his advice. He'll bring them up the way he wants, and above all, he'll oppose every wish of yours.
Alice! Was it he who took my children from me when I parted from my wife?
Since it's past? Yes, it was he.
I suspected it, but I was never sure. So it was he?
When you confided in him and sent him to mediate with your wife, he started a flirtation with her and taught her how she could get custody of the children.
Oh, God! God in heaven!
You didn't know that side of him, did you?
Do you know, last night, when he thought he was going to die, he made me promise that I would remember his children.
But surely you don't want to take revenge on my children.
By keeping my promise. Very well, Alice. I shall remember your children.
That would really be the most terrible revenge you could take on him. There's nothing he loathes like magnanimity.
Then I may find myself revenged by doing nothing.
I love revenge, as I love justice. It makes me happy to see evil punished.
You still feel like that?
I always shall. Today I forgive or love an enemy. Call me a hypocrite.
Oh, Alice, it can be a duty sometimes to leave things unsaid, to turn a blind eye. It's what's called charity, and we all need that.
I don't. I've no secrets to hide. I've always played clean.
That's a big claim.
I could claim more. What have I not suffered for this man whom I never loved?
Why did you marry him?
Why did I? Because he took me, seduced me, I don't know. And then I wanted to get into society.
And gave up your work?
Because society despised it. But you know, he cheated me. He promised me a good life, a beautiful home, and all I found was debts. The only gold I ever saw was on his uniform, and that wasn't real. He cheated me.
Alice, when a young man falls in love, he dreams of the future, and one must forgive him if his hopes don't always materialize. I have the same guilt in my conscience, but I don't regard myself as a cheat. What are you looking at out there?
I'm looking to see if he's fallen.
Has he fallen?
No such luck. Didn't I say he always cheats me?
Well, I'll go and see the doctor and the governor.
You go, Kurt, dear. I'll sit here and wait. I've learned to wait.
Act 2. The same. Daylight. Alice is in the armchair, right. She is gray-haired.
Good morning, Alice.
Good morning, Kurt. Sit down.
The steamer's coming in.
I know what to expect if he's on it.
He is. I saw the glint of his helmet. What has he been doing in town?
I can work it out. He put on his parade uniform, which means he was going to see the colonel, and he took his suede gloves, so he must have been doing the social round.
Did you notice how quiet he was yesterday? Since he gave up drinking and overeating, he's been a different person. Calm, reserved, and considerate.
I know. If that man had always been sober, he'd have been a frightful danger to the world. Perhaps it's a good thing he made himself ridiculous and harmless with his whiskey.
The genie in the bottle has tamed him. But have you noticed how since death set its mark on him, he has acquired a kind of dignity and an exaltation? Perhaps the prospect of mortality has caused him to rethink his views on life.
Oh, don't you deceive yourself. He's plotting some evil. And don't believe what he says. He's a premeditated liar and a born intriguer.
Alice! What's this? You've become gray-haired in these 2 nights.
No, Kurt. I've been that for a long time. It's just that I've given up dying it since my husband became a dead man. 25 years in this fortress. Do you know it used to be a prison once?
A prison? Yes, you could guess that from the walls.
And from my complexion. Oh, even the children became prison-colored in here.
It's difficult to imagine children playing within these walls.
They didn't often play, and the 2 who died withered for lack of light.
What do you think will happen now?
He'll attempt some coup de grace against you and me. I saw a familiar glint in his eye when you read him that telegram from Judith. He'd have liked to take his revenge on her, but she's out of range, so his hatred transferred to you.
What do you suppose he's planning?
Hard to say. He has an incredible gift for, or luck at, nosing his way into other people's secrets. You must have noticed how all yesterday he lived himself into your quarantine, sucked vitality out of your children, devoured your children alive. I know him, Kurt. He's a cannibal. His own life is passing from him, or has passed.
I got that impression, too, that he's already on the other side. His face has a kind of phosphorescence, as though he was in a state of corruption. And his eyes flame like will-o'-wisps over graves or marshes. Here he is. Tell me, do you think he could possibly be jealous?
No, he's too proud for that. Show me the man I need to envy. That's what he said.
Thank God for that. Even his vices have some merits. Shall I go out and greet him?
No. Be offhand to him, or he'll think you're up to something. And when he starts lying, pretend to believe him. I know how to translate his lies. I can always find the truth from them with my lexicon. I feel something dreadful's going to happen. But, Kurt, don't lose control of yourself. My only advantage in our long war has been that I've always been sober and had my wits about me. His whiskey was his weakness. Now, we'll see.
Good morning. Forgive my sitting down like this, but I'm a little tired.
Good morning.
Good to see you.
How are you?
Fine, just a little tired.
What news from town?
Little but good. Amongst other people, I saw the doctor, and he says there's nothing wrong with me. That I can live for 20 years if I take care of myself.
He's lying. Well, that was good news, my dear.
Yes, it was.
Say nothing. Make him speak first and show his hand.
Did you say something?
No, I said nothing.
Kurt. Old chap.
You see, he's off.
I was, in town, as you know. I, made the acquaintance, amongst others, of a young cadet in the artillery. Since we're short of volunteers on this island, I arranged with the colonel that he should be allowed to come here. This should please you particularly when I inform you that it was your own son.
Oh, the vampire, you see!
Under normal circumstances, this news would please me. But as things are, I find it quite painful.
That I don't understand.
You don't need to. It's enough that I don't want it.
I see. That's how you feel? Well, you must know that the young man has been posted here and is now subject to my orders.
Then I shall make him apply to another regiment.
You can't. You have no rights concerning your son.
I have no...
No. The court has awarded them to his mother.
Then I shall contact his mother.
Oh, there is no need.
No need?
No. I've already done so. Yes.
Now he must die.
He is a cannibal.
So, that is that. Did you say something?
No. Have you become hard of hearing?
A little. But if you move closer, I'll tell you a secret. Between us two.
There's no need for that. And a witness might be a good thing for both parties.
Quite right. Witnesses are always a good thing, but first, is my will ready?
The lawyer has drafted it.
In your favor? Good. So, that's that. Yes.
Have you ever seen a human being like him?
He isn't a human being.
Oh, Alice. I wanted to tell you something else.
Yes?
Well, in view of your oft-expressed wish to terminate the misery of your unhappy marriage, plus the complete lack of affection shown to your husband and children, plus the negligence with which you have handled our domestic economy, I decided during my visit to town to deposit at the courthouse a petition for divorce.
Oh, and your reason?
Well, in addition to the reasons already listed, I have personal ones. Now that it has been established that I may live for another 20 years, I have decided to exchange my present unhappy state of matrimony for one better suited to my position. I intend to unite my destiny with that of a lady able to bring into my home not merely a wifely affection, but also youth and, shall we say, a hint of beauty.
Go ahead!
She throws away her ring! Will the witness be so good as to note this?
And you intend to throw me out and put another woman in my house?
Yes.
Right then. Let's have it all out. Kurt, this man has been guilty of the attempted murder of his wife.
Attempted murder?
Yes, he pushed me into the sea.
Without witnesses?
Oh, he's lying. Judith saw it.
What's that got to do with it?
She can testify.
No, she can't. She says she saw nothing.
Oh, you've taught the child to lie.
Oh, I didn't need to do anything. You taught her already.
Have you been seeing Judith?
Yes.
Oh, God.
The fortress has capitulated. The garrison is granted a safe conduct in 10 minutes from now. 10 minutes. By my watch. Ow!
What is it?
I don't know.
Do you want something? Would you like a drink?
Whiskey? No, I don't want to die, Alice. Don't touch me. 10 minutes. Where the garrison will know what to expect. 10 minutes.
Who is this man?
He's not a man, he's a demon.
What does he want with my son?
He wants to have him as a hostage so that he can have you in his power. He wants to isolate you from the island's authorities. Do you know what this island is called by the people who live here? The Little Hell.
I didn't know. Alice, you're the first woman who has ever made me feel sorry for her. All the others have seemed to me to deserve their fate.
Don't abandon me now. Don't leave me or he'll beat me. He has beaten me for 25 years, and in front of the children. And he's even pushed me into the sea.
I can't try to be his friend any longer. I came here with no thought of malice. I was even willing to forget how he humiliated me and blackened my name. I even forgave him when you told me it was he who had taken my children from me, because I could see he was sick and dying. But now that he wants to take away my son, he must die. He or I.
Good. Don't surrender the fortress. Blow it to hell and him with it. Even if we have to go with him. I'll find the gunpowder.
I wasn't angry with him when I came here. When I felt your hatred infecting me, I thought of running away. But now, I feel an irresistible duty to hate this man as one should hate evil. What can we do?
I've learned my strategy from him. Get his enemies together. Look for allies.
Fancy his managing to track down my wife. Why didn't those two meet 25 years ago? That would have been a match to make the earth tremble.
But now they have met, and they must be parted. I know his Achilles heel. I've long suspected it.
Who is his worst enemy on this island?
The ordnance officer.
Could we trust him?
Yes, and he knows what I... Yes, I know it too. He knows what the sergeant major and my husband have been up to together.
Up to? What do you mean?
Embezzlement.
Oh, it's horrible. Look, I don't want to have anything to do with this.
You can't strike an enemy?
I could once. Not anymore.
Why?
Because I have discovered that in the end, justice is always done.
Then you're prepared to wait? Till they've taken your son from you? Look at my gray hairs, yes, feel how thick they still are. He's planning to remarry. So I am free to do the same. I am free. And in 10 minutes, he will be sitting down there, under arrest. Down there. And I shall dance above his head. I shall dance the march of the boyars. And I'll play the piano, so that he shall hear. Oh, the fortress will open its gates, and the sentry with the drawn sword will no longer stand guard over me, but over him. Titty-tum-tum-ta, titty-tum-tum-tay. Him.
Alice, are you a devil like him?
I shall wear these as I march out of this place. The laurels of triumph, and the ribbons will flutter. They're a little dusty, but they're evergreen, like my youth. I'm not old, Kurt.
You are a demon.
In my little hell. Look, I'll make myself ready. Give me 2 minutes to dress. 2 minutes to see the ordnance officer, and then up goes the fortress.
You are a demon.
You always used to say that when we were children. Do you remember when we were children and said we'd marry each other? You were shy, of course.
Alice.
Yes, you were. And it suited you, you see. There are coarse women who like shy men, and there are said to be shy men who like coarse women. You liked me a little even then, didn't you?
I don't know where I am. What are you?
An actress who isn't scared by our conventions and is a woman. And now I am free. Free. Free! Turn your back and I'll change my dress. Looks like Christmas here.
Well?
Thank me. 6 witnesses. 4 of them irrefutable. The application has been dispatched, and the reply will come on the telegraph. Here, into the heart of the fortress.
I see.
Say thank you, not I see.
Why has he lit so many candles?
Because he's afraid of the dark, of course. Look at the telegraph. Doesn't it look like the handle of a coffee mill? I grind, and the beans crunch, like extracting a tooth.
What's he been doing in this room?
It looks as though he's been making preparations to go. down into the cells. That's where you'll go.
Alice! Don't talk like that. I think it's horrible. He used to be my friend when we were young, and he was often kind to me when I was in trouble. I feel sorry for him.
What about me? I did nothing to anyone and had to sacrifice my career for this monster.
That career of yours. Was it so brilliant?
What the hell do you mean? Do you know who I am or who I was?
Now, don't get angry.
Are you beginning to already?
Already?
You're biting me!
Yes. I'm going to bite your neck and suck your blood like a stoat. You have woken the beast in me. I tried for years to stifle it by denying and tormenting myself. When I came here, I thought myself a little better than you two. But now, I'm the meanest of us all. Since I saw you as you really are in all your nakedness, since lust distorted my sight, I realized the full power of evil. It makes the ugly seem beautiful, the good seem ugly and weak. I want to strangle you. With a kiss.
Do you see the mark of the bond from which you liberated me? I was a slave. Now, I am free.
But I shall bind you.
You?
I
thought for a moment you were...
getting religious.
Yes. The other day you began to talk about the fall.
Did I?
And I thought he would come to preach at me.
You thought that. In an hour we shall be in town. Then you shall see what kind of man I am.
Tonight, let us go to the theater. Let us show ourselves. Don't you see? If I run away, the shame will be his.
I begin to understand. It isn't enough to put him in prison.
Oh, no, it isn't enough. I want him shamed, too.
A strange world. You commit the deed of shame, but he must bear it.
That's the world's fault.
Oh, these walls. It's as though they'd soaked in all of the evil of everyone who's ever been imprisoned here. One needs only to breathe here to be infected. But you are thinking of the theater and supper? I've been thinking of my son.
Fool!
Forgive me.
On your knees, then. On your face. Kiss my foot. Get up.
What have I come to? Where am I?
You know quite well.
I think I'm...
May I speak with Kurt? Alone?
Is it about the safe conduct?
Kurt, will you please sit with me for a little? Alice, will you grant us a moment's peace?
What's this? Here's a change. By all means, sit down and hearken to the voice of age and wisdom. If a telegram comes, leave it to me.
Can you understand the purpose of a life like mine? Like ours?
No. As little as I understand my own.
What is the meaning of this chaos?
In my better moments, I've believed that the meaning of life is just that. That we should not know the meaning, and yet we should bow to it.
If I have no fixed point outside myself, how can I bow to it?
Correct. But you, as a mathematician, should surely be able to find that unknown point, given certain data.
I have looked for it and have not found it.
Then your calculations have been at fault. You must start again.
I will. Tell me, where did you find such resignation?
I have none left. Don't overrate me.
As you may possibly have noticed, I have understood the art of living to be a question of blotting out the past. Forget and go on living. When I was young, I made a little bag and stuffed into it all my humiliations. And when it was full, I threw it into the sea. I don't believe any mortal being has suffered as many humiliations as I have. But when I blotted them out and went on living, they ceased to exist.
I've noticed what kind of a life you've created for yourself, and for those around you.
How else could I have lived?
How are you feeling?
Bad. Then there comes a moment when the ability to create, as you call it, stops. And then reality stands forth in all its nakedness. It's terrifying. You see, my dear friend, forgive me. When I was in town just now and spoke with the doctor, he said I was all to pieces and that I couldn't live long.
Did he say that?
Yes, he said that.
Then it wasn't true.
What? Oh, yes, that. No, it wasn't true.
Was the other thing a lie, too?
How do you mean, old chap?
That my son was to be ordered here.
I've never heard any mention of that.
You know, your ability to forget the past is quite unbelievable.
Old chap, I don't understand what you mean.
Then you are all to pieces.
Yes, there isn't much left.
Perhaps you haven't petitioned to divorce your wife, either.
Divorce? No, never mentioned it.
Then you admit you've been lying.
Old chap, you use such strong words. We all need a little indulgence.
You've realized that.
Yes, I have realized that. Forgive me, Kurt. Forgive me everything.
Bravely spoken. But I have nothing to forgive you. And I'm not the man you think any longer. Least of all worthy to accept your confessions.
Life was so strange, so hostile, so cruel. Ever since childhood. People were so cruel that I became cruel too. What are you looking at?
Can one shut off a telegraph machine?
Not easily.
Who is Sergeant Major Osberg?
He's an honest chap. A bit of a dealer, of course.
Who is the ordnance officer, then?
He's my enemy. He's my enemy, all right. Not a bad fellow, really, though.
What are they doing with that lantern? Out there, by the guns.
Is there a lantern?
Yes, and people moving.
Probably what we call a welcoming committee.
What's that?
A platoon with a corporal. Some poor devil's going to be arrested.
Oh.
Well, now that you know Alice, what do you think of her?
I can't say. I just don't understand people at all. I find her as inexplicable as I find you and myself. I'm getting to the age where, if one's wise, one admits one knows nothing and understands nothing. But when I see something happen, I want to know the reason. Why did you push her into the sea?
I don't know. It just seemed to me quite natural when she stood there on the jetty that she should go in.
Have you never regretted it?
Never.
That's strange.
Yes, it is. So strange that I can't believe it was I who could have done such a paltry thing.
Did it never occur to you that she'd get her revenge?
God knows she has, and I find that equally natural.
How have you come to be so cynically resigned in such a short space of time?
Since I looked death in the eyes, I've seen life from a different standpoint. Kurt, if you had to judge between Alice and me, which would you say was right?
Neither. I feel infinite pity for you both. Perhaps a little more for you.
Give me your hand, Kurt.
Old friend.
Charming. Did I hear the word friend? Hasn't the telegram come?
No.
This delay is making me impatient, and when I get impatient, I hurry things up. Look, Kurt, I'm going to finish him off now, and this'll settle him. First, I load. I know the drill, if anyone does, the famous rifle drill that didn't sell 5,000 copies. Then I take aim. Fire. How is your new wife, that young, beautiful, unknown girl? Huh, you don't know. But I know how my lover is. He's splendid, but he's still shy. You scum, whom I never loved. You were too vain to be jealous. You never saw how I led you by the snout. Help! Help!
Judas, avenge me!
He's dying, thank God.
Not yet. Judith! Judith!
Now I'm going with you.
Go to hell whence you came. Goodbye. Forever.
Don't leave me, Kurt. She'll kill me.
Kurt, don't leave me. Don't leave us.
Goodbye.
What a wretch. There's a friend for you.
Forgive me, Alice. And come here. Come quickly.
That man is the most contemptible and hypocritical wretch I've ever met in my life. At least you're a man.
Alice? Listen to me. I can't live for long.
Oh?
The doctor told me.
Then the other thing was untrue, too.
Yes.
Oh, God. What have I done?
Nothing is irreparable.
Yes, this is irreparable.
Nothing is irreparable, as long as one blots out the past and goes on living.
No, but the telegram! The telegram!
What telegram?
Are we damned? Did this have to happen? I've destroyed myself. I've destroyed both of us. Why did you let yourself be fooled, and why did this man have to come and tempt me? We are lost. Everything could have been all right. You could have forgiven me.
What is it that cannot be forgiven? What have I not forgiven you?
I know, but this time there's no help.
I know how inventive you are in evil, but I can't guess what you're going on.
If I could undo it, I would take care of you. EDGAR, I would love you.
Listen to her. What is going on?
Do you think no one can help us? Yes, no mortal can.
Who could, then?
I don't know. Think, what will become of the children? Their name will be dishonored.
Have you dishonored our name?
No, not I, but they'll have to leave school. And when they go out into the world, they'll be alone, like us, and evil, like us. Then you didn't meet Judith either, I realize now.
No. But block that out, too.
Oh, no, it's happening! Oh, don't listen to it!
I won't listen to it, dearest child. Calm yourself.
Don't listen!
I'm holding my ears, Lisa, my child.
Oh, God, help us! They're coming to arrest you! God in heaven! It's all right. It was nothing.
What secrets have you got there?
Don't ask. It's over now.
As you wish, my child.
You wouldn't have spoken like that 3 days ago. Why now?
Alice, the first time I fell, I was a short while on the other side of the grave. What I saw I have forgotten, but the impression remained.
What was it?
Hope of a better...
Better?
Yes. I've never really believed that this was life. This is death. Or something even worse.
And we...
It was our destiny to torment each other, it seems.
Have we tormented each other enough?
Yes, I think so. I think so. Shall we tidy up after us? And leave things clean?
If we can.
It won't be done in a day. Not in a day.
But sometime.
Let us hope so. So you didn't escape this time. But you didn't get me put away either. Yes, I knew you wanted to have me put in prison. But I blot that out. You've done worse things than that. You know I didn't embezzle that money.
Now you propose that I shall be your sick nurse.
If you wish to be.
What other choice have I?
I don't know.
But this is eternal hell. Is there no end, then?
Yes, if we are patient. Perhaps when death comes, life begins.
If only that could be true.
You think Kurt was a hypocrite?
I'm sure of it.
I don't think so. But everyone who comes near us becomes evil and moves on. Kurt was weak, and evil is strong.
how banal life is nowadays. In the old days, one fought. Now one merely threatens. I'm pretty sure that in 3 months we will celebrate our silver wedding. With Kurt to propose the toast, and the doctor and Gerda will be there. The ordnance officer will make a speech, and the sergeant major will lead the cheers. And if I know the colonel correctly, he'll invite himself. Yes, you laugh, but do you remember Adolf's wedding, that fellow in the hussars? The bride had to wear her ring on her right hand because the bridegroom, in a fit of tender passion, had chopped off the third finger of her left hand with a jeweled penknife. Are you crying? No, I believe you're laughing. Yes, child. Sometimes we cry and sometimes we laugh. Which is more fitting? Don't ask me. The other day, I read in the newspaper that a man had been divorced 7 times, ergo had married 7 times, and in the end ran away at the age of 98 and remarried his first wife. There's love for you. Is life serious or just a hoax? I don't know. When it's a farce, it can be a nightmare. When it's serious, it can be quite soothing and tolerable. But when you finally decide to play it serious, someone always comes along and treats you like a clown. Kurt, for instance. Do you want to celebrate our silver wedding? Say yes, Alice. They'll laugh at us. But what of that? We'll laugh too. Or be serious. Whichever way it turns out.
Yes. Let us.
Well then. Our silver jubilee. Blot out the past. And go on living. Let's go on.